Hey everyone, this is Mike from Mike's Do It Yourself. Today I'm going to show you how to do a run cap replacement on your blower motor for your air conditioner or heater. And for your application, it may be down on the ground, or it could be a split system where your blower motor is up in the attic, and that's the way this one's set up. So I'll show you how to get to it and how to replace it. But first of all, you want to make sure your power is off, your breakers. This one has a switch that's turned off, and the breakers are off, and the thermostat's off. So you just want to make sure all the power is off before you attempt to replace your capacitor. Using a quarter inch socket, take these two screws out and this panel will come out. The same thing, it's a quarter inch screw that needs to be taken out. Loosen it up a little bit more. See the terminals on it. The specs on this, it's a 370 volt AC, 10 microfarads, plus or minus 6% deviation on that 10 microfarads. So I'll show you how to test that. You want to put your connectors on the same way you took them off. But they aren't labeled, so it's not as important when you have just a single run capacitor. only two terminals like this. And you can put them on any one of the terminals just because it's all going down into the run cap. You get the terminals back on, you can tighten it back in there. Your strap may be larger or smaller than this one, and you may have to make it smaller or bigger because of the size of your run cap. If it's not the same size, like I said, you may have to make it smaller or bigger. You may have to use a different kind of strap just to attach it. And when you're handling these, you want to make sure that you discharge them because they store an electrical charge. So the best way to do that is just to have an insulated handle, and this one's plastic. So you'll just want to go from one terminal to the other terminal, and that'll discharge any electrical charge that it may have stored. And that's the easiest way to do it. Now, if you had a dual run capacitor, you know, you'd go from one terminal over, you know, the other terminal over, you know, and just do that until you've gone all the way around. And that way, in case you accidentally touch metal to metal on these and you're holding the metal, you're not going to get shocked. So just a little bit of safety on that. Okay, now this is the capacitor that was taken out from the attic, and as you can see, it's 10 microfarads, and that's just a measurement for capacitors. And what there's two plates in here. This is filled mostly with oil, and there's a separation between the plates. And what we're going to check right now is to see how close to 10 microfarads this is going to come up to. And I'll show you how to do that. If you have a multimeter, you'll want to turn it to the microfarads, and this will go up to 200 microfarads. And so on these single run microfarad capacitors, you'll be able to move these terminals, or you'll be able to attach these terminals to either side because there's nothing that says common on this. And so if there was a common, you would put the black lead onto it. But as you can see, you know, it'll just go from one to the other. So just attach it like that. You attach the other one like that, and then it may take a few seconds for it to move up or down. And so as you can see, this one is reading 8.7, and the majority of the times you'll see this bubble up on the top, and it's still really flat. But as far as our reading is concerned, this is bad. Just because when this says 10, you have a 6% up or down. So it should be 9.4, or it could go up to 10.06. So that is why this is bad. Or excuse me, 10.6. So it could be 9.4 or 10.6 reading, and it would still be okay because you have that 6% tolerance. So And these are available on, you know, Amazon or other websites. And what you want to get is, you should get a spare for each one that you have on your AC or furnace system. You may have two, you may have three, but you just want to make sure you get the same volts, alternating current. So this one's a 370. And then of course, if you're in the US, you'll have a 60 Hertz. And then just check on your microfarads, your percentages, just get as close as possible as you can on your margin of error. And this one's protected, and then you have some of the other lettering and numbering here. So you want to get something that's very similar to the one you have, but the main points are the microfarads and your voltage. Well, this has been Mike from Mike's Do It Yourself. Thanks for watching, and good luck on your next home or automotive project.